Let's take, for instance, the crescent kick. Come in. Okay, watch, from the front, where nobody uses it. They all use the crescent kick from here. Come in, Mark. Okay, but see where I hit the crescent kick? I like the shoulder. Okay, I'm not gonna hit the elbow. I like the elbow. I like the wrist. Okay, crescent kick is a hard kick to deal with. Okay, switch a little bit. Hard kick to deal with. Okay, from the front foot, come in. It's a nice kick for the kidney. You don't set up from in for the kidney. He's tailor-made for the kidney. How do we get our power out of it? Bring it from the floor. Okay, but use it rather than just use it to come in. Okay, it's a very valuable kick. If you do want to come in, hit his hands. You know, if I hit his hands that side, I'm not doing it hard. I know I can come in this side. Okay, I know he's vulnerable. Turn. In fact, I won't say turn, I'll just go this way. Okay, so if I was fighting and I came in, you see me come right in on that side, I don't have to fear getting hit with that punch because I came in, I hit that. Okay, that side. This is the one I have to worry about. So use that crescent, okay, to get into an opponent. And it doesn't have to be a full crescent. It can be a half crescent. Then it can be a crescent that shoots like a front ball kick. Here it is here. Watch. Nerve centers. Feels like there's not a lot of power in it, but the weight of the leg alone, if we ripped it off Mr. Boyce and we beat Mr. Pierce with Mr. Boyce's leg, he would feel it. Believe me. The leg is very heavy. It's one of the heavier body parts. So once again, I come in, crescent kick, straight in. So what it enables me to do is get on top of him. Okay, to use my hands. From the crescent, don't use another kick. Okay, there's not enough time. If I came in and I crescented and then I hooked, it puts me in a bad position. Okay? You know, for fighting position. It's not good for balance. Make sense?